She intended to find out exactly what was going on. Linda was altogether too sharp for his liking, and it annoyed the hell out of him how willing she was to pay the so-called correct amount of tax. He didn't let himself smile, but he and his friend didn't do that. She grew even more suspicious when two police officers came into the agency soon afterwards and asked to speak to him privately.
"You can say whatever it is in front of me. I'm not only his wife, but his business partner."
They looked at him questioningly. He didn't dare do anything except agree.
"It's all right for her to be present."
The two of them might no longer share a bed, and he was planning how to get out of the relationship with his money intact. But no one else knew that. As usual, Linda took over. She gestured to the customer seating and jerked her head at him.
"Perhaps you could lock the outer door, Don dear, and we'll all sit down. We may as well make ourselves comfortable. I'm sure these officers do more than enough standing around."
She didn't say much as the policeman told him what had happened and asked questions about the recent sale of the Marrakin property, but the thoughtful looks she shot in his direction at one or two of his answers made him shiver. He'd been really happy when she decided to leave the real estate business to his care, because it didn't bring in a good enough income for them both. That had left him free to make extra money tax-free by cooperating with a very savvy guy he knew. It was worrying him big time that she was poking her nose in again suddenly. What had made her decide to do that? Had she heard something? If she had, she didn't say anything after the police had left, except,
"I'll continue going through the books."
Oh, hell.